first man aged in his 30s has become the youngest Australian to die from COVID-19. He's among a dozen people to succumb to the disease in Victoria in the past 24 hours. The virus-riddled state has also recorded another 466 cases. Health authorities say the numbers appear to be stabilising, but they're still too high.
It's almost easy to become desensitised to Victoria's daily coronavirus figures, but not today.
He was not a health worker, I can confirm that.
He was a man aged in his 30s, and he's one of the dozen Victorians lost to coronavirus in the past 24 hours. The state has recorded 466 new cases and 12 deaths. Six of those are connected to aged care. 636 people are in hospital, 44 of them are in ICU. And of those, 29 are being kept alive by ventilators. Victoria now has 7,808 active cases.
The effect of many of the stage four changes, it's only days old, so we're not going to start to see impacts of these measures for a little while.
It's expected to take another 2 weeks for Victoria to see the effects of its harsh lockdown.
Certainly we're seeing some stabilisation in numbers. We've got 400 to 500 cases each day. That has been more or less the average for the last week. That's not good enough.
The Premier has rejected suggestions the state is running short on PPE.
We have 68 million gloves, 19 million surgical masks, 2 million face shields and 530,000 goggles. They're all in the warehouse at the moment. They're being distributed each day.
And the Chief Health Officer has denied Victoria is battling a more brutal strain of COVID-19.
I don't think there's any evidence that we've got a tougher virus in terms of its transmissibility or its severity. We do have the challenge that the world has of second waves.
They say Victorians just need to do the right thing and stay home. But many are not. In the past 24 hours, Victoria Police has issued 197 fines to people breaching lockdown laws. 39 of those were given to people who refused to wear a mask, while others were disobeying the curfew or travelling way outside their permitted 5 kilometre radius.
Don't make those selfish choices. Don't think that somehow you're entitled to do things that no one else is allowed to do.
And it seems won't be allowed to do for quite some time. Candace Wyatt for 10 News First.